Our next guest is a BBC anchor who received a call from the Taliban live on air. Yalda Hakim was hosting the network's World News when she began interviewing a member of the extremist group.
I'm just going to interrupt you because... Okay, we've just got spokesperson of the Taliban, Sohail Shaheen, on the line. Mr. Shaheen, can you hear me?
Yes.
Mr. Shaheen, there is a lot of chaos and confusion in Kabul at the moment. Can you just help us understand what the Taliban plan to do at present and next?
Yes, there should not be any confusion. Kabul, their properties, their lives are safe.
Yalda Hakim was born in Afghanistan, but her parents fled to Australia when she was a baby. She later became a reporter in Sydney before moving to London in 2012. And BBC anchor Yalda Hakim joins us now from London. Yalda, thanks so much for joining us. Why did the Taliban spokesman call you?
Well, Koshi, you know what it's like as a journalist. You have your series of networks, contacts, connections. And that night, I didn't sleep at all because I was so worried about the fall of Kabul. And I thought, if I sleep and I wake up and Kabul has fallen, you know, the devastation of all the women and all the people that I know in this country was just seemed unbearable. I stayed up till about 4:30 in the morning. I managed to wake up about 6:30, and I had a message from my boss saying, you need to come into the studio right now, Kabul has fallen. So as I sort of got myself to the studio, on the way there, on the tube, I sent him a text message and I said to him, you need to explain to people what's going on because there's a huge amount of devastation. I've got young women messaging me, calling me, saying that they're so frightened the Taliban are outside their window. They're afraid of what they'll do to them for wanting to get an education or for working or for having an independent life. You need to explain to the world and to the Afghan people what on earth is happening.
Yeah, they did that. The Taliban member said Afghan lives are safe, and overnight Taliban leaders vowed to protect women's rights during an extraordinary press conference. Let's take a quick look at that.
The Islamic Emirate is committed to the rights of women within the framework of Sharia. The international community, if they have concerns, we would like to assure them that there's not going to be any discrimination against women, but of course within the frameworks that we have.
Yalda, do you believe them?
Koshi, they have history. They were in power in the 90s. I went to Afghanistan just 3 weeks ago, before the fall of Kabul. And on my way to Kabul, I went to Doha and met with Sohail Shaheen, who you heard there earlier when he rang me. And he said very similar things. But then when I went to Kabul, I interviewed a frontline commander and I asked him what law and order would look like, for example, or if someone committed adultery, what would that look like? And he said, well, of course, we'd stone women who would commit adultery. And we would conduct public executions. And of course, if someone stole something, we would amputate their hands and feet. So it's got to be beyond the statements that they're giving at press conferences and the sorts of things that they're saying in the media.
Yep. Yalda, what did you think of Joe Biden's address yesterday when he said, if Afghans aren't willing to fight for their country against the Taliban, why should anyone else?
Well, I think if anyone understands the history of the last two decades and understands how this war was fought, I've been generals all week. I've been speaking to David Petraeus, who was led the US command in Afghanistan. And he said to me today that he thought it was not right for Joe Biden to say that. He said, you know, I led men in that country. I lost men in that country. And I have to say that the Afghans who fought alongside US troops, British troops, Australian troops, they were some of the bravest men. And we do not think that those statements were the right thing to say. And so he said it was quite unfair, as have other American generals that I've spoken to.
Okay. Yalda Hakim, an Aussie made good in the UK. Congratulations on your career over there and thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much, Koshi.